Welcome to People Doing Good for Others. People Doing Good for Others, where we celebrate and highlight and hold in the light those who truly make significant contributions in our communities. I'm Gary York, and I thank you for this opportunity. I want to thank Wilkes Communications, River Street Network, and WIFM for this opportunity, and again, thank you for being with us. Our featured guest today is Ryan Bledsoe. He's a commercial loan officer with the Carolina Farm Credit in Wilkesboro, a native of Yadkin County. He's a volunteer fireman, and I'm really excited about hearing something about that part of his career. Wife and family, and continue to live near Jonesville. So thank you for being with us, and good morning to you, my friend.
Good morning, Gary.
Ryan Bledsoe, tell us about family and growing up in Yadkin County and going to Jonesville Elementary School.
Okay, so I grew up in Jonesville and still live about a half a mile from where I grew up from. I went to Jonesville Elementary School and am a graduate of Starmount High School, and just love the area. I love Yadkin, Wilkes, and Surrey counties. You know, it's just a great area to live, and it's a great area to raise a family in. So I've always enjoyed being here. So.
You want to talk about Starmount High School? It's a good time to kind of ease us into
sure.
our journey today.
Yeah, sure. So I loved Starmount. I still love Starmount. I always enjoyed playing sports and things of that sort. And I had two teachers that were really memorable while I was there, which is Mr. Parrish and Mr. Martin. Both of those guys really wanted to see their students succeed, and just made an impression on my life. And you know, they taught us how to think outside the box and really prepared
think
us.
Think outside the box.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Yep. So they really wanted to prepare us not only for the lessons they were teaching, but for the life that we was going to live after high school. So I really appreciate those guys and what they done during our high school career. So, yep.
What did the roles they played? The courses they taught.
So Mr. Parrish was our honors English teacher.
And honors English.
Honors English teacher.
Wow.
And Mr. Martin was our auto mechanics teacher. And they both done a really good job teaching their subjects, but they also done a good job teaching about life skills as well. So.
Wow.
Yeah.
And you had you're involved in sports?
Yes, sir. I played basketball, soccer, and tennis while I was at Starmount. Not all 4 years, but I played basketball for 3 years, tennis for 4 years, and soccer for a couple of years.
How did you get interested in tennis? I just wonder.
Well, there's a funny story to that. I had played baseball up until I got to high school, and my soccer coach was also the tennis coach, and he encouraged me to play tennis instead of baseball. And so I done that and really enjoyed it. Tennis became my primary sport. You know, I wasn't the greatest at it, but I really enjoyed it and had some good memories from that. So,
did you play doubles and singles?
We did. We played doubles and singles, and just enjoyed the teamwork that it took to accomplish what we wanted to accomplish in the doubles teams.
Yeah.
So,
back to the classroom and honors English. Is that something that did you love to write or think?
No, that was more of a decision of my parents than me. So, and I appreciate that now.
I bet.
The things that they done to push me along and encourage me was great. I had wonderful parents growing up, and they really encouraged me and pushed me along to exceed further than what I maybe thought I could. So, I appreciate that.
I have some significant interest in Jonesville Elementary. You say you have a son there now?
Yes, sir. He is
Talk
in.
Talk about him and your wife.
Okay, my son is will be 5 next week, and he is attending the pre-K program at Jonesville. And It's like I say, I went to school there, and now he's following in my footsteps. So it's kind of neat to see him grow and proceed through that as well. So my wife is Ashley Bledsoe. She works for Yakin County in the health department and has been there for a little over a year and a half, but she's been a nurse since 2007. And so nursing, it was her calling, and she could tell you that from the get-go, that that's what she wanted to do, was be a nurse. So.
Where did you meet?
She was a Star Mount graduate as well, but we didn't actually start dating until after I had graduated. So we met at Star Mount, but then got to know each other later on, just kind of hanging out in Elkin. So.
Now, she has a significant leadership role today in her nursing. Tell us about that, Ryan.
Yes, she is a nursing supervisor for the health department. So she's over the nurses in the Yakin County Health Department. So.
Okay.
Yep.
Then there was an opportunity to go to Winston-Salem State. How did that transpire? And go there for me.
Okay. So I have always been a homebody. And so when I graduated Star Mount, I didn't really want to move off too far. So I went to Surrey Community College and obtained my associate's degree. And then there was some sickness in my family with my dad, and so I didn't really feel like I needed to move off. So I started looking at my options, and Winston-Salem State was a school that I could go to, still live at home and commute back and forth. And so it really worked well. Got a good education at Winston-Salem State, and I appreciate, you know, what all went down while I was in school there. So.
Ryan Bledsoe, tell us some more about driving back and forth, and that being a day student, but it worked for you.
It did. I actually was working part-time for Flow Chevrolet in the parts department, and so I would go to school and then come back to Flow Chevrolet in Winston and work, and they was really good to work with me on my school schedule. So, you know, if I had morning classes, I could come in the afternoon, or if I had afternoon classes, they would allow me to come in the morning as long as I was able to do my job. And so they worked with me really well, and I appreciate that.
Well, I remember that about the Flow Company, mm-hmm. that education was important to the leadership at Flow, too.
Yes, it was. It was.
Wow. So you could kind of work whatever the schedule of school came first,
yep.
And they would allow you to come in and work when you could.
That's right.
Wow.
Yep, they was great to do that. So.
Okay.
Yep.
So you did that for a couple of years?
I did. I worked there for about 2.5 years and worked there through my tenure at Winston-Salem State.
Yeah.
So, yep.
Yeah. Winston-Salem State. Yep. What was your major there?
I majored in business administration and had a concentration in management, but that was my major, was business administration.
Okay.
So, yep.
Wow. So then Carolina Farm Credit, was it immediately after that?
No, so I went to work for a credit union in Winston for about a year and a half, and I wanted to be back in the area that I live.
Okay.
And opportunity came up, and actually was hired in November of 2008 as a loan officer in the Yakinville branch at Carolina Farm Credit. And it just fit. I've always been enthused by agriculture. My uncle was a big tobacco farmer, and I've had a lot of friends that were, in farming. And I thought, you know, this is a good match. This allows me to be involved with agriculture in a way, and still utilize my degree and be able to help customers in a great industry, which is agriculture. So
the combination of helping people, mm-hmm. and in the agriculture arena, mm-hmm. that's kind of came together for you. Those two things being of significant value for you, the ag and
yes.
being able to serve people.
That's right.
The culture of Carolina Farm Credit. Now let's go there and the values, the things that we believe.
Okay. So Carolina Farm Credit is relationship-based. We want to develop relationships with our customers who are actually members. Carolina Farm Credit is a cooperative. So you, the members become owners of the company, and we pay back a cash dividend as long as it's approved by our board each year from the profits that we made from the previous year. And so there's benefits to being a cooperative for our members, and that's just one of those benefits is the cash dividend. It is a great opportunity. Our members can vote on our board of directors, and several of our board of directors are farmers that are just like our every other member. They're members as well, and so we're out for the best for our members, you know, because that's who we serve. So.
And let's talk about being part of the Wilkesboro office.
Okay.
And where is it, and how long have you been over here, and just go from there for me.
So we are located at 902 Curtis Bridge Road in Wilkesboro. I have been in the Wilkesboro office since 2016. Located within our office is our regional manager, Scott Green, and then we have a regional loan support supervisor, Ashley Wayne. The other loan officer that is located there is Marsha Williams. And then our branch office coordinator is Carmen Church, and our loan processor is Alexa Wagner, along with myself. And that's the staff that makes up the Wilkesboro office. So,
an office of that size, share you the scope of area that you serve.
Okay. So in the Wilkesboro office, we primarily serve the Wilkes County area.
Wilkes County.
We do. Within the region, we have Wilkesboro, Yakinville, Pilot Mountain, Sparta, and Jefferson that is within our region. And, you know, those serve those particular areas. Jefferson does serve the Watauga area as well. So,
okay.
Yep. But throughout the Carolina Farm Credit footprint, we serve 54 counties in the western part of North Carolina out of 30 different offices.
30?
30 different offices.
Okay.
Yep.
We often hear about Statesville.
Mm-hmm.
Now, your relationship of the Wilkes County to Statesville.
Okay.
How does that work?
So Statesville actually has two offices. They have the regular branch office, and then our administrative office is in Statesville as well,
okay.
Which is where our CEO and our executive leadership team is housed. And so that's the primary operations of the company there. So.
Ryan Bledsoe, you, as a commercial loan officer, share with us a day. Just like what might happen in your role as a commercial loan officer in Wilkes County? Just
okay.
How would a day be for you?
Okay, so we take in applications and phone calls to help customers anywhere from. You know, we have poultry farms that we finance that all the way down to residential lot loans that if somebody's wanting to buy a lot to build a house on in the future, we can finance those. And we also finance, you know, equipment loans and cattle loans and things of that sort. Anything that would serve agriculture or rural North Carolina, we can take a look at. So,
and a person would come in and start with an application process, maybe.
That's correct. Yep.
Go from there, if you will.
So, if you're wanting to apply for a loan, we would go through the application process, and you would provide financials and the application itself, and then we would go through underwriting, order appraisals if appraisals are needed. If an attorney is needed, we would contact the attorney that the borrower wants to use, you know, to close the loan if it's a real estate loan, for example. And usually takes about 45 to 60 days to do a real estate loan.
45 to 50 days?
Yeah, 45 to 60.
60, okay.
Yeah. Real estate loans can take that just because there's appraisals that have to be ordered, attorneys have to be involved, and so you're working around some other schedules, not only our schedule, but those schedules as well. And but now equipment loans and cattle loans of that sort, you know, they don't take 7 to 10 days most of the time. We can turn those around pretty
quick.
You
do line of credit too?
We do. If a farmer is needing an operating line of credit to establish his crop for the new year, we can take a look at those as well. Yep.
And you also would finance a cattle operation?
We do.
I thought that was quite interesting. Tell me about how that works, Ryan Bledsoe.
Okay, so there's actually two different types of cattle operations. There is a cow-calf operation where an individual may buy cows, and each year they breed those cows to sell the calves off. And so those types of loans we can set up for generally 3 or 4 years and let them pay back from the calf sales each year. And then there is a feeder cattle program that, you know, where somebody buys a calf at a certain weight, they raise it up to another certain weight and then sell it off. And most of the time those are short term. And so we'll set those up on a 12-month or less term for those guys to have time to raise those cattle to a certain weight and sell them off. So.
Driving over this morning, I know this beautiful, there's four house chicken poultry houses mm-hmm. Have beautiful red roofs.
Yeah.
And what is the magic about four? Is there a... Tell us how that works, Ryan Bledsoe.
So the cost to build poultry houses has increased over the years just through inflation and things of that sort. And so a lot of farmers that are getting into poultry or wanting to build poultry houses realize that, you know, just one may not, you know, provide them the income that they want. So they end up building two, three, or four. And then sometimes that is dependent on the integrator that farmer is going to go through, you know, if they're needing.
That word, tell us about that word.
Okay, so the integrator is going to be your Tyson, your Wayne, okay, your Mount Air, the poultry company that you're going to contract through. And so, you know, they.
Integrator.
That's right.
Okay.
So they may be, you know, needing a specific number of houses. And so that's where that comes into play too, is that farmer talking with that poultry company or integrator to determine, you know, how many houses they need and so forth.
And you stay involved with the farmer and through the whole process.
Yes.
Tell us a bit about the poultry side of it and how the working and what does the person, the owner, okay. Tell me about the role he plays in the day-to-day operation about that.
Okay, so the poultry farmer is going to get up and, you know, they're going to go out and feed and work through the chickens. It just depends on what type of operation. If it's a breeder operation, they're going to be picking up eggs and walking the houses to make sure that the poultry operation is doing what it should be doing.
Wow.
If it's a breeder or a broiler operation, you know, they're raising those chickens up to a certain weight, and so they're going through and making sure that the feed is running correctly, that they're, you know, that they're being watered like they should be, and going through the houses to make sure that that everything is clean and sufficient.
Water's a critical piece of it, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Tell us, will you expand on that a little bit?
So water, you know, in poultry, water has to have poultry. Chickens have to have a certain amount of water, and you know, cleaner water for them means a better product at the end for the poultry company. So,
okay, yeah. Wow. So now again, tell me the different types of operations
okay. With
the relationship of the integrator to the poultry manager or the owner.
Okay.
Once
so
again.
there's breeder operations where the poultry facility, the farmer raises the chickens and they lay the eggs that goes to the integrator. There is a broiler operation where they bring smaller chickens out and they raise them up to size, which is what ends up going to our plates for our
right.
supper and dinner
right.
and you know, different restaurants and things of that sort. And then there's pullet operations where they raise smaller chicks up to a size that those birds are sent to the breeder houses.
Okay.
So,
all right. Yep. Ryan Bledsoe, so there's a significant change every day. You may 2 days not be alike. That's part of your career I'm sure you really enjoy.
Yes, correct.
Okay.
One day we may be talking about, you know, with customers about a poultry operation. The next day we may be talking about a home finance. Somebody's wanting to construct a home or something like that. So it's different day to day. which makes it interesting. We get to talk with and work with several different folks, which I enjoy. I enjoy the relationship side of our business and getting to know the individuals that we're helping, getting to know, you know, their operations and what their passions are is what I enjoy. So.
And you also work with building inspectors and the county health people, and
we don't handle that on that side. From a home construction side, you know, we would go out and either the appraiser or the loan officer would go out and inspect the houses to make sure if it was a construction, to make sure it's on target for where it needs to be. But as far as the you know, the home inspections from the county and the contractor would handle that. So.
Let's revisit, if you will, the different programs that you offer to the mostly the rural community. And again, so we do this, this, and this, if you will.
Okay. So our number one thing is lending for rural and rural living and agriculture in North Carolina. But we do have a financial services division where, you know, if you're needing investments, life insurance, things of that sort, our financial services money concepts department can help with that. We have an appraisal department. So, you know, if you've got a property that you're looking to purchase, but you don't really want to start an application, but you want to see what that property is worth, you can call and our appraisers can come out and do an appraisal. Or if you just want to see what the value of your existing property is, they can come out and do that. You know, we have different community outreach programs that we do through Farm Credit. One of those is our Corporate Mission Fund. The Corporate Mission Fund was established for two reasons or two objectives, and that was to invest in agriculture in North Carolina as well as to improve or enhance rural America or rural North Carolina. And so the Corporate Mission Fund is a grant program that organizations can apply for up to a $5,000 grant to you know, use at their disposal for whatever project they're looking for, as long as it meets our parameters. The grant process starts January 1st through June 30th is the application period. And then the grants are awarded in the fourth quarter of each year.
I heard about the two that last year. You want to mention those?
Sure. So Miller's Creek Fire Department and the Wilkes Community College Agricultural Department both received one of our grants last year. And it's nice being able to see those funds being come back to local. And so that's important, and that's important to Carolina Farm Credit as well.
So there are grants that go to nonprofits, and you said the community college. I can't think of a better opportunity. Yeah. Wilkes, the ag part of Wilkes Community College.
That's correct.
And also the Miller's Creek Fire Department. Can you give us an idea of, let's get a little deeper into that, if you will.
Okay, so Wilkes Community College, their early college also received a grant a couple of years ago. They were starting a bee program.
Bees?
Yes, sir. They was wanting to start a bee program to teach their students how to manage the bees and how to work bees and things of this sort. So that was a unique opportunity. And so they was able to use those funds to purchase some of the hives and things of that sort. And so, you know, hopefully that will enhance those students' careers. So, yeah.
Wow. Ryan Bledsoe is a commercial loan officer. Tell again the process, those grants that will be available. Those that are see us today might say, well, my nonprofit is going to need some money for. Tell us how the timing of that, if you will.
So grant application is all online at CarolinaFarmCredit.com. And the grant application period starts January the 1st, and it goes through June the 30th.
Okay.
And then there is a committee, a grant committee that oversees and looks through the applications. And then those applications are awarded in the fourth quarter of the year. So between October and December of each year. So if anybody's interested, I encourage them to go visit CarolinaFarmCredit.com. Click on the About Us tab, and then the Community Support tab, and then the Corporate Mission Fund will be under that.
Okay.
Yep.
Wow. Ryan, with I want to go back to the start, or the, if you will, your company. Was it 1916?
1916. The Farm Credit System was established in 1916 to provide a reliable source of income or financing for agricultural and rural America. Carolina Farm Credit is a part of the Farm Credit System. And so we are proud to serve North Carolina, the 54 counties that we serve in agriculture and our rural residents.
Okay. Your office, your staff, do you have a weekly sales meeting, or how does that work in an office? Just describe your office on Curtis Bridge Road.
Okay, so yes, we do have a weekly meeting. We get together Monday mornings most of the time. And talk about our week, talk about what we've got going on, talk about different maybe closings that we've got that week, or different customers that we're going to go visit, and things of that sort. So we try to stay in touch with our customers. We like I say, we want to build a relationship with our customers. It's not just a situation where you close the loan and we don't hear from you. We want to hear from you. We want to talk with you.
So you revisit the yes. site of your folks who maybe borrowed some money, built poultry houses. You continue those relationships.
Yes.
And you want to be asked to help.
That's right.
Right.
That we want to be involved as much as that customer wants us to be
now,
involved.
Now, you've told me twice as much this morning the things that you do that I had no idea.
Yeah.
Yep. Way to go.
So,
thank you very much for your preparation today.
You're welcome. Yep.
And I want to make sure we talk about being a volunteer fireman.
Okay. All right. Growing up, my dad was involved in the volunteer fire department for about 9 years. And I started playing sports, and he wanted to be there for me at ball games and stuff, so he set the volunteer fire department aside. And it kind of upset me at the time, because I wanted to go with Dad to the fire department. And so, when I became 18 years old, I thought, I'm going to join the fire department. And so I did, and I've been there for 18 years and served at Arlington Fire and Rescue. And it's a special brotherhood.
What is it about it? Tell us what is it that we love about it?
It's a desire to serve our community.
Desire to serve.
It is. It's a desire to serve our community. It's challenging. You have to be a little bit on the athletic side to do. You can't. You need to be a little bit in shape to do the things that we do. And after being involved in it. It's a brotherhood brotherhood and sisterhood. We have
service and brotherhood.
Yep. Okay. The relationships that you build between your firefighters is unreal, because you have to trust each other to be able to do the job. And so
trust.
That's right. So it's a very important and very unique.
So you're going in a house that's like maybe three of you together, and mm-hmm. there's a trust relationship with the men and women. This is what we're going to do and how we're going to do it. And so you're depending on
yes.
working together.
That's right. That's exactly right. So
tell us about the training that goes along every year of you're being a volunteer.
So the state requires, the minimum requirement for a firefighter training is 36 hours a year. However, there's different levels that we want to attain, and so we require more training than that at our station, just to make sure that we're doing and learning and maintaining our skills to do the job. So, yeah.
So, wow, thank you about the brotherhood and service before self.
Yep.
Wow.
Yep.
Back to your church family.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Visit your church for me.
So we attend Swaim's Baptist Church. That's where my wife has always gone to church. And when we got married, that's where we felt led to go. And so I originally went to Bethel Baptist in Rhonda. and had a great church that I grew up in, and several memories that I will hold dear, throughout my life. But so we attend Flames Baptist Church now. We've got a great church. It's a very loving and caring church, and it's just it's a small country church, but that's okay. That's you know, whatever church fits what you're looking for.
So that's a valuable part of your life, an integral part of your life, your son and your wife. And
yes. Yep.
His name again?
His name is Ryman.
Ryman.
Yep.
Like that.
Yep. So.
Ryan Bledsoe, what an honor to have you with us today. And the culture of Carolina Farm Credit, the outreach, the ministry of it, you've shared it in a unique way. And you made it very special for WIFM today to also be a part of the ministry of Wicks Communications, River Street Productions, and WIFM. So if you have a closing statement for us about maybe your career, or what would you like to say? You're certainly a person who walks closely with the Lord, I can tell that.
I am. In closing, God has given us each a gift that we should use. And I feel like everybody that is, you know, has got a gift that God's given them, and we need to use that to serve others. And so I would encourage others to look at what their gift is and see how they can serve. You know, maybe it might be just a small service, but you never know how much that goes toward another individual and how much that can encourage somebody else. So I would encourage everybody to get involved in some way in your community.
And so Carolina Farm Credit is an opportunity for you to use that gift to matter in the lives of others.
That's correct. Yes, it is.
Thank you very much.
I get to experience, sharing our customers' dreams each day.
Their dreams.
They come to us with a dream of what they want to do, and we get to a lot of times see that dream come to fruition, and that's a special opportunity.
So. Thank you. Ryan Bledsoe, commercial loan officer with Carolina Farm Credit, a native of Yadkin County, a person who believes in service, and he does that on a volunteer basis, also his family and his church. And what a blessing to have him with us today. Until we can be together again, please remember that to put family and God and friends ahead of self and to matter in a special way. Ryan Bledsoe, Carolina Farm Credit, until we can be together again, be safe and take good care. Bye-bye.